currently, honeybees are just disappearing all over the country. Tens of millions of them. All right, let's hear some theories about why this might be happening. Nobody? You're not interested in what happened to the bees?
Excuse all the teachers? The administration makes us teach with a foot of snow on the ground. What is this?
There appears to be an event happening.
Security and the CDC
has reported attacks. Boston, Philadelphia,
Maryland. White House officials claim the CIA has a defense against chemical weapons.
I don't understand what you're saying. She says everyone's dead outside.
What's going on?
We lost contact.
With whom?
Everyone.
The government's testing something there that went wrong.
The affected area now includes California.
Authorities are now feeling, by the sheer numbers of attacks, that a terrorist group being responsible is becoming less and less likely.
Science will come up with some reason to put in the books. But in the end, it'll be just a theory. We will fail to acknowledge that there are forces at work beyond our understanding.
Some plants can target specific plants. The film seemed to imply that the plants were purposely knowingly going directly after humans, and that's not exactly how it works. Some plants send out volatile hormones when they are attacked. The signals are evoked by a combination of damage and insect saliva. Predators such as wasps use this cue to find their prey. In other words, wasps have developed sensory apparatus to detect injured plant hormones, so it's not the plant that's calling the wasp to its defense. In other words, plants release chemicals or enzymes as a form of pest control. If a plant gets cut or bit, they release enzymes or juices that smell or taste really bad, which causes their predators to basically leave them alone or end up in death.
Shyamalan suggests that plants might evolve to the point of attack because humans pose a threat to the planet. But it's stressed that individuals don't evolve, populations do, by selecting for genetic variants that promote survival. How quickly it happens all depends on how fast those plants reproduce. Something like trees are going to be very slow because their generation time is low, he says. Something like weeds can evolve pretty fast. In the case of the killer plants, some plants would have to have come up with the killer genetic variant randomly, and over time those plants would have to have been selected because they were more fit than their less toxic relatives. Only in this case, it's not all clear why killing humans would help these plants evolve, especially in places like parks. Plus, says Jenny Cruz Sanders, Director of Research and Conservation at the Atlanta Botanical Garden, it's unlikely across the entire planet that a kingdom that all of these unrelated species would be cruising the same continent.
Botanists agree that plants can emit volatile compounds. There are literally thousands of plants that have neurological impacts on humans when ingested, but researchers have yet to discover any that can emit airborne neurotoxins. And there's certainly no evidence to suggest that plants will emit them on a massive scale, because developing chemical defenses require extraordinary amounts of energy. Producing even simple defense mechanisms has a high energy cost, particularly for big organisms like trees, in common but inefficient. Species such as grass. For the most part, trees are big organisms that, and things eating them are small organisms. Under those circumstances, why expend the energy for chemical defenses? Grasses grow quickly and don't put a lot of resources into the structure or seeds, so the likelihood that they'd be able to emit toxins is nil. Smaller plants with smaller populations, however, are a different story. When getting eaten is a problem for smaller plants, that's a common situation where plants are toxic. But that's not the scenario depicted in The Happening, in which characters spend the bulk of their time running from toxins in the fields of central Pennsylvania, not exactly the hub of exotic plant life.
Essentially, in the movie The Happening, plants collude together in order to release neurotoxins into the air and kill human beings. By doing this, the humans breathe it in and they automatically want to kill themselves, thus exterminating the threat for plants. There is some science to this. Plants have been known to communicate with each other. But it's not a communication like a conversation. Instead, plants sense the presence of other vegetation through photoreceptors and chemical means. When herbivores chew on some types, for example, a plant's response is twofold: chemical to deter the herbivore, and a volatile emission into the air that other plants can sense, then responds with protective chemicals. The same chemicals are not produced when leaves are simply torn or damaged. Some plants have been shown to recognize others nearby that are competing for sunlight. Ripening fruits release hormones that can cause a response in the surrounding plants, and parasitic plants can sense chemicals emitted into the air and soil by other plants. There's even research to suggest that plants have a social life that we, as of yet, don't understand. According to a recently released study by scientists at McMaster University in Hamilton, Ontario, the Great Lakes sea rocket weed can recognize plants related to it. Another recurring theme in the movie was that the plants seem to know when the humans are around and could then activate the neurotransmitters, or the neurotoxins, to go ahead and kill the humans. Plants do seem to have the ability to know when we're around them to some degree. They can't exactly hear us the way that mammals or animals can hear each other. However, they can sense the increase of CO2 that humans give off. So perhaps there is some sort of water given to